This will be a breakdown and a tutorial of the top 10 Revit tools that every beginner should know. Let's go. Now, if you're serious about mastering Revit, go to balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. We are an Autodesk authorized training center and we provide training for Revit. We have over 150 hours of training dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. This is our project 2 from our beginner course. And I'm going to start off with tip number 1, which is pinning elements in place. So when you're working in Revit, a really annoying thing is when you hover over an element and then you accidentally move it. Now, you can avoid this a couple of different ways. The first way is to go here to selection and then go to drag elements on selection and check that off. So what this means is now if I try to move this object, as you can see, it doesn't work. It's not allowing me to do that. Now, I actually like to this feature where I can move, especially furniture, if I want to move something or if I want to move a tag. I like to keep that functionality. So in order to avoid this, and let's say for grids, you want to keep grids in place and you don't want to move them. Well, what you can do is you can go here to pin in place. PN is the shortcut. Once you pin it in place, it ain't moving anywhere. As you can see, I cannot move it. The only way to move it is to unpin it either here by using this pin icon or by going here to modify tab and unpinning it there. Moving on to tip number 2, which is thin lines. So when you're working in Revit, especially if you're doing some detailing work and you're zooming really far in, what you'll notice is that you have these really thick lines and it can be really difficult to work with these lines. Luckily, we have a solution in form of the thin lines tool. So it's just a toggle over here in the quick access menu. TL is the shortcut. And once you click that, all of the lines turn thin, no matter how far you scroll in. And now we can see additional layers here and it's a lot easier to do our work. One important thing to keep in mind is that this will not print like this with thin lines. So this is only for working views. And then once you're done, always turn off the thin lines because you want to see what this will look like once printed. And having thin lines turned off is the only way to see that. Moving on to tip number 3, and that's temporary dimensions. So whenever you're working in floor plans like this, when you select an element, it's going to bring up temporary dimensions so you can make accurate changes to the model. This is really cool. However, sometimes it may show you the wrong dimensions or the ones that you don't want to see. Now, of course, you can always select the witness lines and then move where that temporary dimension is pointing, but you don't want to do that all the time. You want it to be set up correctly out of the box. So you can actually manage that by going here to the Manage tab and go to Additional Settings, Find Annotations, and here you will find temporary dimensions. I'm just going to set this to faces and click OK. So now whenever I select any items, it's going to measure from face to face, which is exactly what they want to see. Moving on to tool number 4, which is the Align tool. So the Align tool is located here on the Modify tab. Here we have the Align tool. AL is the shortcut and it allows us to align elements. I can select this element over here as our base point and then the next face I select, it's going to align it to that face. Now, another cool thing with the Align tool is this little lock icon that appears. So when we align things, if we decide to click on this little lock icon, what Revit will do is it's going to lock in these two items together, so they're always going to be moving together. We can, of course, unlock it and then move them individually in the future if we want to do so. Another thing that we can do when we have multiple items to align is to go to the Align tool and then check multiple alignment. What this will do is once you select the first line, then you can select multiple lines to align to that first line. Moving on to tool number 5, which is Join Geometry. This is a really powerful tool, especially for sections. So for example, here we can see this section and it looks kind of messy, especially here and here, and it's time to fix that. So I'm going to go here to Modify, to the Join Geometry tool. JJ is the shortcut. This allows us to basically join items together and then they look a lot cleaner. You can also do a multiple join if you have multiple items to join together, like I do over here. And then you can just continue joining elements together and see if anything isn't joined together, you can join it. Moving on to tool number 6, which is hide element tool. So whenever you're working in Revit and you want to hide something, a good option is to go just here to temporary hide isolate and hide that element. The only problem is if you decide to close down Revit and open it up again, it's going to reset and this is going to be visible yet again. So if you want to hide it a bit more permanently without deleting it, of course, you can select it and then go here to hide element. EH is the shortcut and now this element is hidden. At any point you can get it back by going down here to the little light bulb icon that's going to reveal hidden elements. You can just select it, unhide it, and then turn off reveal hidden elements, and now it's back. Moving forward to tool number 7, which is the detail line tool. So whenever you don't need to model something, you can just draft it. Just make sure that it's not going to cause issues down the line. So the detail line tool is located here on the annotate tab. We have the detail line tool. Here we can pick out which line type we want to use. I'm going to go with thin lines. And then for example, I can use a circle just to mark the position of the floor drain. If I just need to mark it without actually placing a drain there, well, I can do it like this, and it's a lot easier than finding a floor drain family, loading it in, making the model heavier, placing it there, modifying the family, so on and so forth. This can save you a lot of time. Moving forward to tool number 8, which is very similar to tool number 7, and that's the batting line. So whenever you have a thermal insulation, usually you want to present it by using the batting line. Now here what I can do is I can quickly measure the thickness of this thermal air layer, which is 130 millimeters. Then I can go to my insulation batting line. Here we need to include the width, which is, as I said, so that's going to be 130 millimeters, and now I can simply draw that insulation batting line. If it's a bit too big, you can always select it, make it 110, for example, and then fit it in a little bit better. So that's how you draw in insulation really quickly. Moving forward to tool number 9, which is override graphics in view. In Revit, you can select any element and override its graphics by using this tool. Simply select the element, zoom in, then go here to the View tab and find Override Graphics in View. You can override the element or the entire category. I'm just going to go with the element. And then here we can set up the foreground for the surface pattern, and we can also set up the cut patterns as well as lines. So for example, for lines, I'm going to change them to be, let's say, blue lines, and then the weight, I'm just going to make it a bit thicker. And then for the surface pattern, I'm going to change it to solid fill. And then for color, I'm going to go with some very light orange, just like this. Hit apply. Okay, and there we go. So as you can see, we have that blue outline with the orange surface area, and you can use this to highlight elements in your model. Finally, tool number 10, which is the Create Group tool. So whenever you have elements like this, we have some furniture here. Well, we don't want to have it all separated because it's going to make it a bit more difficult to manage. So what we can do is we can create a group. So here I can just make a broad cross selection just like that, go to filter, and then I'm just going to check the furniture and furniture systems and hit apply. Okay, so now we only have the tables and the chairs. And then what I can do is I can turn this into a group by using Create Group or the GP shortcut. This can we can now name. Let's just leave it at group 1, click OK, so this is now a group. What we can also do is edit this group. So for example, if I want to remove something, let's say I want to remove this whole section, I can hit finish, and now only this is included in the group. Now I can copy this group and manage it however I like. So those were the top 10 tools every Revit beginner should know. Please tell me in the comment section below, would you add some tools into this list? Would you remove some? And also, did you know about all of these tools? Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.